All right. So for past couple of months, we are means conducting this Tableau interview session. So what we thought is today we are going to take it can be a more of a Q&A round where I'll tell you the few basic etiquettes of what are supposed to what are the things that are supposed to happen when you are conducting an interview or when you are attending an interview. What are the prerequisites that you should when you are you should do in order to be prepare yourself to be in a better position, right? After that, so today what we were trying to do is as we have been conducting the Tableau interviews and all the things questions, so there are few of the questions that we have discussed in our previous sessions already. So today we want to know what can be the other questions that you are looking for. Maybe someone may have a very basic level of question, someone may have kind of questions which are very unique, which they may have felt or got during their sessions, during their interviews, and they were not able to answer those kind of questions. So we will try to take those kind of questions as well, which will be a kind of you will be getting the answer for yourself. At the same time, other people in the session will be getting the benefit out of it as well, right? So that was the primary agenda of our session for today. First and the most foremost things is when we are looking for the what happens is look for various Tableau jobs in various sites and portals, right? This is a very basic thing that we do. But the second topic is build a very strong resume accordingly. Now what happens is generally people tend to they spend hours or let's say a couple of days preparing one resume, which is according to them, they feel okay, this is picture perfect. Now I don't have to do any edits in this resume, and I'm just going to take this resume and share it with anyone who come across me and says they are looking for a job. Does this happen, or do you do this kind of thing, right? So that do happens, right? What is the general tendency? We create one resume which we feel is the most perfect resume as per our experience, and we just post it across to the various sites, various portals, various people who are coming across, right? Who says, hey, I have a Tableau job opening. Okay, take my resume. This is the resume that you have, right? Isn't that the thing that we generally follow? You customize your resume each time. What happens is in this, that is how it is supposed to be. But unfortunately, I do take interviews, I do take interviews for my organization for which I'm currently associated with, and I have been in this role for quite a long time now. Now what happens is when we are looking at that resume, I know in my job description I'm looking for a guy who has a SQL experience, who has exclusive Tableau experience, and let's say he has some level of Python experience. But the resume that I'm getting is this guy says, hey, I have an experience of working of 1 year in call center. Then I have worked in a project which was on a Excel. Then I have worked on a project which was on a SQL. Then I moved to ClickSense. Then I came to Tableau. Then I went to Power BI. So if I get this kind of a resume, and my requirement in my job description was very strongly mentioned that I'm looking for a guy who is only having experience, or not solely restricted to, but the majority of it should be in the Tableau and SQL, and let's say to a certain extent of Python, right? That was my job description, but what the resume that I have got was totally different. So according to, in that situation, my initial thought will be this guy is a misfit, right? This guy is a misfit, so let me take the another resume. So that is how this screening or the scrutinizing of your resume do happen. First thing they look is they don't know you as a person. Okay, who is Raj? Who? What does he do? They don't know. The only thing that they know is about you is the resume. So whenever if you are really serious, guys, about cracking a job in a short period of time, this is one thing that you have to do by all the means, which is, I know it's just kind of a tiring process, a kind of a cumbersome process, but try to create your resume or try to modify your resume a little bit or to tweak it in a situation where it can be more relevant towards what they are. If the job is for the Tableau and you are mentioning your call center experience, it's of no use. Cut it. The trainer or the interviewer does not need to know that you have already worked for a call center, which is of no good use in his current role, right? So try to remove the unwanted clutter so that you can have the emphasis on the actual topics which a interviewer is looking for. The chances of your resume getting picked up in those kind of situations are quite high, other than when you have, like, you know, a resume which is like 4 pages, 5 pages, and out of that I have to keep searching, okay, where does this Tableau resume where is this Tableau experience? Oh, here, oh, here. Okay, there's, so it will be in bits and pieces. So one way of, that's my way of scrutinizing the resumes, is whenever I try to find a resume which is of the most fit, which can justify the role that has been mentioned in the job description. Maybe you cannot fake things. I don't recommend people to fake things left, right, center, because what if you are mentioning, yeah, that is the next point that we are going to discuss. Okay, let me not get to that point right now. But yes, in a nutshell, build a resume strongly and according to the job description, right? This is what I was trying to tell you in this point, is build a resume which is very strong to that role. Now, next thing what happens is, one more thing, guys, please refrain yourself from mentioning all the things that you have done in your past, from like start from after your schooling, what you did, what were the which internship you did, which call center you work, all the things, like, you know, literally, I think it was Friday, 2 days back, the Friday evening, I got a guy's resume who has 7 years of experience, and that guy shared me a resume which is 9 pages long. It was a PDF which was 9 pages. I was like, boss, by no means I have patience to read your 9 pages of resume. Maybe he had a lot of content to share, but no one is going to read that much amount of information. First of all, when you say you have a 7 years of experience, people will easily understand, okay, you are coming with a high level of skill set and with a diverse amount of experience. Keep your resume short. Keep one of the few most milestone projects that you have worked, so that people can understand, okay, what level of critical projects that you have worked. At the same time, means you are not missing on some vital information. Try to balance that level of information that should work. Okay, then once you are shortlisted, try to do a little bit of research for the organization. Know the domain, know your job role. These are the few things which we feel, hey Raj, why are you telling me? These are the most basic thing anyone can do. But trust me, guys, the kind of interviews that I am facing, or the people that I am facing when I'm taking the interviews, like, they are missing out on very, very basic things which are kind of creating rejections for them. Unfortunately, I cannot stop them saying that, hey, you should have known this. But those are the basic parameters which we do expect from any person who is trying to apply for a job, right? Couple of technical functional terminologies, like in your resume, if you are mentioning something like, you know, you have worked on tab CMD, or if you have worked on tab PI, if we are having like any terminology which is a kind of a fancy thing that you have worked on, people do mention in their summary, like first few lines of their summary, they'll write on saying that, hey, I have worked on complex charts like Pareto chart, donut chart, and Gantt chart, or something. They will try Sankey charts and all the things they will mention. The moment I ask them, hey, do you know, can you know, tell me what are the most complex charts that you have worked? Then he'll say, no, there are lots of situations where we have to deal with only the basic charts. It's only a donut chart that I have created as a complex chart, right? It's like your resume is saying something and what you are saying is not in synchronization, right? So the person is saying that he has not worked on any Pareto chart or any Sankey chart, but the third or the fourth line in his resume itself is mentioned as he has worked on quite a couple of complex chart. So either when you are mentioning, so know your resume very well, guys. This is one of the things that I would like to emphasize again and again and again, if possible, that whenever you mention any small topic on your resume, just because you went to Google, you searched for resumes, Tableau sample resumes, and you found out something and you just copy pasted it into your summary, and then you go and sit in the interview, the first thing they will ask is all of these outliers. Right? No one is going to ask you the moment you mention, I have worked on, let's say, some most basic things. I have worked on bar chart, I have worked on line chart, I have worked on pie chart. No one is going to ask you a question on that. And if you are going with 3 years of experience, anyone is going to expect that you should have worked on by default line and bar charts. So mentioning that thing in your resume doesn't add sense. At the same time, even if you add that, no one is going to ask you a question on that. Hey, how do you create a bar chart, right? And that's the last thing anyone could have asked you. Now, any outliers, any special keywords that you are trying to put in your resume to make your resume look fancy, make a note of those topics. What are those topics? Now, people do come and say, I have exclusively worked with parameters and we have done various functionality. We have used parameters in various ways. Now, I do ask them, hey, can you tell me what are the limitations of parameter? They'll say, there are no limitations to parameter, which is one big fat lie. Again, like, you know, that is a straight away rejection. Like, I do not even try to ask second or third question to those kind of people when they say that there is no limitation for parameters, right? So those are the very small things that we have to understand when we are trying to you know, attend an interview. If we can know this basics, because many a times I'll tell you what happens, many a times there are few people who are sitting on the other side of the table in couple of organizations who are not the technical leads, who do not have a very strong technical knowledge, but they are being given with a couple of questions and they are being given with couple of answers and they are being given with couple of strategies saying that, okay, if this is there in the resume, you should ask this question. Now, if we are going giving them the resume and that point you are not able to answer, that person cannot ask you any question on their own. They straightly write it a cross mark on your resume and they say thank you for the day, right? So that's a problem. So whenever you are trying to attend the interview, try to be familiar with the technical terminologies as well. Like anything that you have mentioned in your resume, any unique thing. There are so many instances, guys, which I come across almost daily. Like I asked them, okay, if they have mentioned anything in their so they I don't understand when you are writing about, I have worked with Tableau Server, I have worked with Tableau Desktop, I have worked with Tableau Reader. On what thing are you going to work on Tableau Reader, right? There's nothing that you do when you use a Tableau Reader. Why do we want to mention that kind of terminologies which are like obsolete to Tableau, right? So don't just go to Google and try to find out some keywords or some sample resumes and just try to copy paste out of it. Whenever you are creating that resume, try to see that, okay, is this a thing that is relevant to a developer? Like Tableau Reader, for the people who are yet to take the Tableau trainings, it's a kind of a reader which is very similar to a Adobe Reader, right? PDF Reader. What is the job of PDF Reader? PDF Reader is used to open any PDF file. Similarly, Tableau Reader is just there to open any Tableau file offline, right? You cannot work anything on that. So, and that is mentioned in bold in people's resume and in the summary. I have worked on Tableau Server 10.x dot 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 version, 9. Dot dot version, 8. Dot dot version, Tableau Desktop, Tableau Reader. So that's that kind of creates a initial. Very easily you can make it out, okay, this guy doesn't have the experience that he's holding or he's claiming on his resume. All right, now after that, one thing that you have to think of is the mock interviews. What are the mock interviews? You have to sit with someone who knows a little bit of Tableau, or try to frame few of the questions which are available, or ask that person to find out a couple of questions from internet and try to ask you and pertaining, like, you know, create a situation of as if you are sitting in an interview room. The reason I always insist on this mock interview is think of interview as something like this. What, there are two parts of the interviews. Whenever you are sitting in any interview, a person tries to check on two basic things from you. Number one is, for whatever the question that I am asking, do you have a knowledge related to that? Second question is, if you have the knowledge, how are you trying to express yourself? Do you have the ability to form that statements, to have that, you know, formation of thoughts and put forth in a way that other person can receive it, isn't it? So there are two parts: what part, what you know, and the second part is how part, what and how. So what you know and how you convey it, right? So if you sit in some mock interviews with your friends or with your you can have some off late, you can see there are people who are giving you mock interview trainings as well. So you can check with them, or who can give you the interview or training assistance. So what it will do is it will build you the confidence. Okay, if any guy asks me this question, it's similar to how we used to practice for our exams during our school days, right? If we have a final exam, let's say 15 days after. So today we used to sit and write some pre-finals. Then we used to have some. So we used to have some exams, right? Unit tests, semesters, and then pre-finals, and then finals. So why this used to happen? Like, whenever you are writing the same questions in pre-finals, it's kind of, we are trying to get habituated to that kind of environment, right? So so that even if you are finding a little bit difficulty to frame a statement, you can get yourself acquainted to it to frame that statement, so that tomorrow down the line, if you are sitting in an interview, you can easily frame that question because you have already practiced on it and you just give the answer.